Written in these walls are the stories that I can't explain. I leave my heart open, but it stays right here empty for days. She told me in the morning she don't feel the same about us in her bones. Seems to me that when I die, these words will be written on my stone. And I'll be gone, gone tonight. The ground beneath my feet is open wide. The way that I've been holding on too tight, with nothing in between.
First thing I remember was getting such a warm welcome. I remember the superintendent, when she interviewed me, described this place as being a battle zone. And I walked in, it was totally the opposite. Everybody was so friendly, so kind, so outgoing. And I felt so good. I just sort of said to myself, I've got to keep this up. I've got to make other people feel the same way. So it was that warm welcome that I'll never forget. First of all, from a personal viewpoint, you make the most of all the good things that come, make the least of all that goes. Really, it's keeping that smile on your face and being able to share it. If you've got a few people you can say hi to every day, they say hi back to you, it really, really gives you a lift.
When I got hired, I was still working construction. I was in university at the time. So I came here on my lunch hour from construction. Anyways, I came in through this side door over here. And for some weird reason, I just always remember coming in that door. And when I retire, which is very close, I'm actually, when I pack up all my stuff, I am going to leave out that door, the same door that I came in 30 years ago. I've been here since 89, 90, 30 years. I've enjoyed every single solitary second of being a Mustang. The time has gone like that. Enjoy your time while you're here. It'll go quickly. Cherish it. I'll always be a Mustang. I've actually loved it. It's my only job I've ever had. I started here and will end here. And it's been a fantastic ride. And enjoy it when you're here. It's a great school.
Walking into St. Martin's was coming into my first actual full-time teaching job. So arriving on Rosemary Drive, I saw two lovely little schools and I thought, wow, what a big campus. And then I saw the portable, my home for the rest of my teaching years at the old school. I never had an inside classroom until we went to the holding school or made it into the new school. So I have to say, my first impression was, oh my, this is my home for the next almost 30 years.
When I walked into St. Martin's as a grade 9 student, I remember is just the sheer amount of people. The school used to be packed. There was over 1,700 kids when I started here in grade 9. And I just remember feeling very overwhelmed. But by the end of the day, you kind of warmed up and realized people were just having fun, like nobody was actually being mean. So it was a memorable first day.
It's interesting, my past students are now my colleagues. I have to say I must have done something right, or the school has done something right. We have created some really wonderful teachers. We've also had great successes from our past students and alumni to be able to see them and say that you had a small part. To my current students, I say do your best. You are our future.
The secret to surviving St. Martin's, I think, is getting involved in something. It doesn't have to be sports. It could be something musical, student council, athletic council, a team, some sort of involvement, because I think you develop relationships with people, your peers and your teachers and the admin, on a different level, and it just makes the whole experience here much richer, much more enjoyable. I think if you just come sort of check in and check out, it's not the full high school experience. So I think getting involved, investing in your school, investing in the community, you get so much more out of the high school experience.
It just takes some The first thing I remember about walking into St. Martin's is being a nervous grade 9 student, meeting all the teachers for the first time. As well, I remember having a pond here at St. Martin's, which was located just outside the library on the outside little courtyard, and that's where I used to study all the time and look at the fish, so I kind of do miss that. And I just remember being very nervous, but now it's changed.
The secret to surviving St. Martin, I think it would be to keep a positive attitude, to not let things get you down, to really remember that the people that, you know, either the students or the staff, that they all have a good heart and we can really count on each other.
I got a feeling that I never really had it, that tonight's gonna be a good night, that tonight's gonna be a good night. I say the same thing every single time.
You know that I can be somebody.
Open up your plans and damn your dream. Hey. Look into your heart and you'll find love's gone.
Down.
Now, I'll be over now, but I feel it still. My most memorable moment as a teacher would be just teaching alongside teachers that have taught me when I was a student is a shout out to my 2018 marketing class, our marketing fair. That was a super successful event and we had a lot of fun doing that together.
We are definitely blessed to be living in a country like Canada. So my advice is, don't ever forget who was here before the rest of us.
You know, just to come in with a positive attitude, and keep on learning. Lots of patience. Good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be